Welcome everyone. Assetto Corsa after Christmas. Had a maybe not a long break, but a break from Assetto Corsa, and decided to progress a little bit within the game on my road to platinum. If I can do some more special events maybe today. It will be a little bit of two in one because it's going to be the first time I'm going to use the age shifter. First time I have gotten it a few weeks back. I was using sequential, but I haven't been trying to use the age shifter. The last time I used the age shifter was probably 3, 4, maybe 5 years ago, quite a long time ago. So it will be a bit of learning, I guess. Maybe trying to get my muscle memory to kick in and take over. Heel and toe braking plus the age shifter. I'll take something slow to start with, something in a special event. I was actually thinking about the Toyota GT86 at Magione, a short track and a car which should be a bit easier to control than some older cars like that Audi here. So let's see how it goes. So Toyota GT86 Magione. Well, we can't change anything here, but we can change a few things here, which they're not visible at the moment because of the camera. We have automatic gearbox at off, automatic clutch at off, automatic leap at off, and the rest, yeah, all factory standard settings. The most important things are the automatic bleep and automatic clutch are both on off. Okay, so let's jump in. I don't expect to achieve a lot. I pick up special event and I pick up Hotlap because that's a good combination for the learning. So what do we have? We have 1 minute 32 seconds for gold. If I was driving on a sequential on the paddles, that probably shouldn't be that big of a problem, but because we are driving on H pattern, first time in the long time, so yeah, it may be a bigger of a problem. Let's use the amount of fuel we have to 10 liters. There's not much more I can change here. Semi-slicks, that's what I'm going with today, I guess. Grid, echo, yeah, no, let's go semi-slicks. I won't be changing anything because I don't know what to change here for that car on the track. It's no point. Let's just drive. Okay, sequential, no, H, yes. So first gear. Good start. I told you it'll be a learning process. Let's restart. I need to get used to that gearbox. Okay, that was better. And let's see how it goes. It's really hard to move from braking with the left leg to braking with the right leg. Obviously when I'm using sequential and paddles, I don't have to use the clutch and I can use left leg for braking. Or here I'm using a right leg for braking. I guess. close to. I need to improve just a little bit to get the tier 3. Third gear here, now I'm going on the second. I found some time here actually, that's what I thought would happen. And that should be tier 3 and gold. I was much quicker than I was expecting it. I actually thought I won't achieve it on the H pattern. This is the first time I'm using the H pattern, but yeah, okay, that I achieved gold quite quickly. Two laps, that's what it took. That's a big surprise. Let's find another special event. I guess this one was just an easy one. I could do a quick race, but yeah, that's a thing. But that would have to be done on an alien difficulty. I think I'm not ready for alien difficulty with the H pattern. Let's try to find some more hot laps in an easy to drive car. Well, it may be hard to define an easy to drive car, something slow. That Abarth should be slow. I'm actually not sure if that car has an H pattern in real life, because that's our kind of racing edition. Maybe it actually has a sequential gearbox or paddles. Let's have a look. There are no information here for the car. There's technical specification, but it tells me nothing about the gearbox for that car. Let's see how it looks like within the car. It's automatic clutch off and automatic bleep off. It's the same racetrack, so that's good. Going to reduce the amount of fuel. Oh, this car, this is a racing car, so it has quite a lot of settings to change. I'll be just changing fuel level, I guess. Slicks. Okay, 1:25, so it's 7 seconds quicker than the Toyota, the requirement for tier 3 or gold. First thing first, how does it change gears? Okay, so I know that he moves his hand to change the gear with the stick, but I'm not sure if it's sequential or H pattern. The only thing I can check here is how many pedals this car have. If I do adjust cockpit view, POV a little bit. See the pedals, shouldn't I? Maybe I'll be able to see the stick itself. I'll change it back. I'm just going to save it just for now. Looks like an H pattern. We have three pedals, so this is H pattern. Okay, so that's what we know. Let's go back with the settings, because this is really... Okay, that should be okay. Cool, let's see what I can do here. And I damaged the gearbox. Okay, so I, instead of upshifting, I downshifted. So let's restart. I'm so sorry for it. Abarth. It's all about getting used to this shifter. It's quite loose on these corners. And it's tier 3. Wasn't too hard as well. That was quick as well. Another gold. Obviously those are quite slow cars, so it's much easier to do the H shifter. Like if I took this Ford, that probably would be quite hard. I don't think I'm ready. I need much more practice, like hours of practice before I'll be ready to do some serious H shifter driving. Let's take it slowly. That could be quite interesting, that Nismo. I'm assuming that Nismo has H pattern. Silverstone. I so don't like Silverstone. It's such a boring track. Porsche. So this is a good question. Does Porsche 718 Cayman S have a sequential paddles or H stick? I don't know. I don't know. But Mazda will definitely have an H-stick. The question is, can I do a quick race? Am I good enough? Probably not good enough at that stage. I wish there was some kind of filter just to filter hot laps so quicker. Here we go. Barcelona GP, Giulietta. Let's see that. Again, manual clutch, automatic bleep off. It's a long version of the Barcelona, the Grand Prix version. That should be 2 minutes 25 seconds is the time to achieve for gold. So much fuel, it's not a racing car, the consumption will be quite low. I'm assuming that's a H butter. downshift to the second, or actually negotiate the turns on third, like I'm doing here. This is a bit of a guessing game. Okay, another one done. It's going quite nicely. Three done. Three hot laps already. Let's look for another one. A bit of quick races. More quick races. Hot laps, but in a very specific car, it's not something I'm looking for. Nordschleife Endurance Cup hot lap. That will be long. It's within the H stick. But that Mazda on Brands Hatch looks very tempting. Let's try it. I won't be changing anything, I'll just drive it. Oh, the bumper engine sounds great. Now I have the H stick on the right side. Finally, on the car with the wheel on the proper side. Okay. That's going to be interesting. Mm-hmm. that car actually revs quite high, 8,000 RPMs. That lap is wasted, but it's a practice lap. So much easier to drive with the H pattern or even sequential. But it's so much fun driving with the A stick. Tier 3, done. Oh wow. With so many mistakes, I'm really surprised. The requirements are so low for those gold medals. I want to see if I can move the thing. I think I could further improve it if I continue doing those laps one after another, but there's no need. So I did what? 1:47 was the requirement. So quite a low requirement for a tier 3 gold to achieve. Should I look for another one? Those BMWs, I'm expecting them to be quite hard, but it's quite quick race anyway. McLaren should have puddles, I guess. But old Porsche will definitely have HD. Zandvoort. I don't remember the racetrack. I would have to learn the racetrack, and I still don't want to learn it at the moment. What else do we have here? Plenty of fast cars, even the old cars with the gear stick would be quite hard to drive, so I want to avoid them for now. Picking cars which are good for learning driving with the H pattern. That Alfa Romeo, but it's Nordschleife, so it's a very, very long. Not necessarily want to do it today. Okay, so what's that? That is Maserati. In BMW M3. Should I try this one? Let's try this one. Silverstone GP, BMW M3 E30 Group A. I have no idea what Group A means for that BMW. Not a big fan of BMW, so yeah, I don't know much about them. It's kind of racing car, right? Definitely H pattern. Too old for anything else. 2 minutes, 22 seconds for tier 3 gold. Yeah, let's give it a try. Quite funny because that BMW wrecks quite high, 8,000, but because it's scaled to 11,000, it feels like it can go higher, though it cannot. Whoa. Locks wheels like crazy. Good brakes, I was braking way too early. Whoa. third, and I go to the fourth, and I destroy the gearbox. And that mistake was because of the late shift, and yeah, that seemed to be happening. That will take a lot of time and practice. Get it all good. Blip wasn't strong enough. I didn't keep the accelerator strong enough, and I lost control in a second. Yes, the art of racing. These old cars, these old stickers, is not the old shifters. I had a lot of space there when I was negotiating previously. Now the exit is too slow, I think. Yes, I'm losing time. So 4th gear is optimal. Not enough power. I missed the corner. I wouldn't be as much fun as it is with the H pattern. try fairly clear here. Wasn't too bad actually. Well, a bit too wide. Surprised on the time that actually I forgot about driving. So I think it's 2:22, not 2:25. 2:25 was for tier one. Tier three. That would be much harder. Time when I actually went from third to fourth, probably to second. too slow. Because it was too slow, it was so easy to put that car into a spin. The front left tires are already gone. Well, they're not gone, but they're yellow. 222. I'll try again. Quite fun to drive that car. And it's a good way to practice the edge shifter. That should be close to, that should be tier 1, right? I think I'll give up with trying to do that BMW. I need a bit more practice with that H shifter. It was fun. It was just tier one out of tier three. I think I'll pause here with Assetto Corsa. It was an hour pretty much at that moment. I need a bit more practice, and then I'll come back to those harder to drive cars, harder to drive with the H shifter. For now, I would like to thank you all for watching, and I will see you next time.